Okay, good day again mga kapwa law student, lalo na sa mga working law student dyan, tsaka mga may family na law student. So, I hope that you are feeling great right now kasi towards the tail end na tayo ng first semester, no? Some of you have already done with their first semester, tapos na yung mga final exams na before nagpasko, while yung others is hanggang 29 or 30, meron pang exams. Kami naman, in our case, we still have two more on the 27th and on the 29th. Today is December 26. It's already Monday. So, itong upload ko ngayon is about, again, the Criminal Law 1, Revised Penal Code Article 11 under justifying circumstance. Okay, so, tignan natin yung disclaimer ko. Ang video na ito ay ginawa ko as a pamamaraan sa pag-aaral. And hindi po ako lawyer sa ngayon kasi nag-aaral pa tayo, pero soon we will be lawyer, we will be one. Hindi rin ako eksperto sa field na ito. But we will try our best to dissect the provisions of the law kasi nga nag-aaral tayo sa ng batas. I am just expressing my idea and how I understood the subject of criminal law. So, let's go now to Article 11, Justifying Circumstance. Article 11, Justifying Circumstances. The following do not incur any criminal liability. When we say do not incur, hindi siya nagkakaroon ng criminal liability. Okay, so, number one, anyone who acts in defense of his person or rights, provided that the following circumstances concur. First, there's unlawful aggression. Second, reasonable necessity of the means employed to prevent or repel it. And third, lack of sufficient provocation on the part of the person defending himself. Now, first, let us try to define what is a justifying circumstance. Now, a justifying circumstance is an act of a person are said to be in accordance with law, so that such person is deemed not to have transgressed the law and is free from both criminal and civil liability. So, pag sinabi natin na justifying circumstance, there is an exigency, okay, to justify the act. Merong exigency or pangangailangan ng pagkakataon. So, kaya ka gumawa ng act na ito. And justifying circumstance is an act was done but no crime and criminal liability and civil liability except paragraph number 4. So, yun yung definition ng justifying circumstance. Now, ito yung nakikita natin ngayon, itong Article 11 ito, this one, okay, so, when we say justifying circumstance and then we saw this one, itong tatlong exceptions na to, okay, so ito, itong circumstances na to, yung mnemonics ko dito is URL, okay, unlawful aggression, reasonable necessity, and lack of sufficient provocation, so URL, okay, so, and all of this pertains to what we call as self-defense. Okay, so meaning of unlawful aggression. Unlawful aggression is equivalent to assault or at least threatened assault of an immediate kind. People versus Alconga, 78 Philippines, 366. There is unlawful aggression when the peril to one's life, limbs, or right is either actual or imminent. Okay, so itong case si Alconga, itong first dito na definition of aggression is that ito yung isa sa mga popular cases din, ano, na saan nagkasuntukan sila doon sa parang guardhouse nila and then tumakbo yung aggressor. Ang nangyari ngayon, yung in-assault is naging aggressor na kasi hinabol niya doon all the way palayo and then napatay niya yung dating aggressor na ngayon ay naging victim. Okay, so, then, there must be actual physical force or actual use of weapon. So, pag walang gamit na force or weapon, then that is not a unlawful aggression. Diba? Kung ginamitan ka lang ng bibig, blah, 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 ganun, that is not unlawful aggression. Okay? Kung ganun, sinisermonan ka lang, that is not unlawful aggression. So there must be an actual physical assault upon a person or at least a threat or inflict real injury. So, merong actual physical assault na nangyayari or threatening. So, merong threat na there is an injury that will be assessed to you. Like for example, may taong nagdadala ng bolo or yung ano, yung bolo. Eh? So, the mere fact na nagdadala na siya ng bolo, naglalakad, there is no threat there. Eh? There's no threat of inflicting a real injury. Now, habang naglalakad siya, papalapit siya, nakatingin sa'yo, and then, tinaas niya yung bolo. He raised up the bolo. And, tumakbo papalapit sa'yo, then that is a threat now to inflict real injury towards you. And then, papasok ngayon si unlawful aggression. Now, in case of threat, the same must be offensive and positively strong. O, ginahabol ka na nga, di ba? Tatagain ka na ng bolo, showing the wrongful intent to cause an injury. So there must be a real danger to life or personal safety. Yun na, hinahabol ka na, naglalakad ka lang, naglalakad siya. Nung makita ka niya, tinaas niya yung bolo, tapos atakihin ka. There is an attack. So kaya napatakbo ka or magkakaroon ng pamaraan na you are going to defend yourself. And that is unlawful aggression on the part of the person na i-attack ka. People versus Kagalingan, GR number 79168. Okay, so, yung unlawful aggression is that it should be imminent. Ayan na, existing. Okay, so magaganap na that you have to use reasonable necessity to prevent or repel it. Okay, then, when using the reasonable force to prevent or repel it, you should have to consider rational equivalence. Okay? So, ano ba yung rational equivalence? Kailangan, hindi sobra yung gagamitin mo na force to repel or to prevent it. Yun. Susutukin ka lang ng tao, tapos binaril mo siya. That is not a reasonable force. Tama? So, kailangan, reasonable equivalence, I mean. So, hindi yan reasonable equivalence. Okay? So, gaya ng case ni, may isang case doon, yung babae. Kalimutan ko yung pangalan, yung exact title ng case. Pero, habang sa loob ng simbahan, hinawakan yung, ano niya, yung binti niya. Binti ba yun? No. Yung legs niya. Okay? Hinawakan yung legs niya ng lalaki. And then, ginawa niya is sinaksak niya sa leeg at napatay niya. So, that is not a rational equivalence. Okay? Now, eto, example. Nag-away kayo ng kainuman mo. Nagkapikunan at bumunot ng kutsilyo ang kainuman mo. Tumakbo ka pero hinabol ka niya at inabutan ka. Swerte na hindi ka niya sinaksak pero nagsuntukan kayo. Nung nagsuntukan na kayo, natumba siya, at nakita mo ngayon yung kutsilyo na gamit niya kanina na sa lupa. Okay? So, ang ginawa mo is that kinuha mo yung kutsilyo at dinampot sabay saksak sa kanya. Now, in this case, there is no self-defense. Okay? Walang self-defense dito. Because once you have subdued a person, then there is already no unlawful aggression. Now, ikaw na victim kanina is now the aggressor. So, nagiging aggressor na. Okay? So, kaya ano? Actual physical force and use of weapons. So, sa example na binigay ko kanina, merong kutsilyo. Now, mere insulting words addressed to the accused, no matter how objectionable, kahit na hindi pa makain ng aso yung pinagsasabi sa'yo, without physical assault, could not constitute unlawful aggression. Okay? It could only go to defamation. Okay? Insulto lang. Words lang yan. Salita lang yan. So, walang unlawful aggression because there is no actual use of physical force and use of weapons. Eh kung yung bibig, yung bunganga niya is naging machine gun yun, ipatay ka na. Pero again, there is no use of weapons and there is no use of physical force. So, in this case, pag iniinsulto ka, okay, gaano man yan kasakit, pero walang physical assault, hindi pa rin magkakaroon ng unlawful aggression. What you can do is that you can file for defamation. Number two, a light push on the head with the hand does not constitute unlawful aggression. Kung tinulak lang yung ulo o tinapik, then walang nangyari doon na unlawful aggression. So, there's no unlawful aggression. Pangatlo, okay, so, a mere push or shove not followed by other acts does not constitute unlawful aggression. Tinulak ka sa likod o sa harap. Pero walang kasunod na acts. Tinulak lang. Eh, it does not constitute a unlawful aggression. So, walang unlawful aggression dyan na mangyayari. Okay? Take note, in the requisites of self-defense, if one is not present, then there is no self-defense. Therefore, you are criminally liable. So, ano yung requisite dun? Unang-una, letter U, unlawful aggression. Pangalawa, letter R, reasonable necessity of the means employed to prevent or repel it. Pangatlo, lack of sufficient provocation on the part of the person defending himself. Pag isa wala dyan, yung pinaka-importante, pag wala yung first part, okay, since it is a requisite, kailangan sunod-sunod to, dapat mayroon. So, starting with unlawful aggression. If in the first place, wala si unlawful aggression, then there is no self-defense. Then you are criminally liable. Pasok si unlawful aggression, pero walang reasonable necessity of the means employed to prevent or repel it. So, wala pa rin self-defense. Pasok si self-defense, pasok si reasonable necessity, pero walang lack of sufficient provocation kasi ikaw yung nag-provoke. Then, wala rin self-defense. So, therefore, you are criminally liable. Okay, so, okay, if you are defending a property, then it is not rational equivalence. Okay, so hindi rational equivalence na ang buhay ng tao ay ikukumpara mo doon sa property. Okay, so hindi talaga. There, it, you cannot invoke self-defense. Okay, so, battered woman syndrome. Okay, so, battered woman syndrome refers to a scientifically defined pattern of psychological and behavioral symptoms found in women living in battering relationships as a result of cumulative abuse. Three phases of cycle of violence. Number one, the tension building phase. Number two, the acute battering incident. Ito na. Yung una, tension pa lang, tension building. Siguro, nagkakasagutan pa lang. Yun, sigawan. Pangalawa, yun na, acute battering incident. Meron ng bubuga na nangyari. Then, yung pangatlo is that the tranquil loving or the non-violent phase. So, ano nangyari ito? Bumalis sa labing-labing. Now, dalawang cycle nito, the woman can invoke self-defense if napatay niya yung husband niya under the battered woman syndrome. Okay, so, Article 11 pa rin, number 2, requisite. Anyone who acts in defense of the person or rights of his spouse, ascendants, descendants, or legitimate, natural, or adopted brothers or sisters, or of his relatives by affinity in the same degrees, and those by consanguinity within the fourth civil degree, provided that the first and second requisites prescribed in the next preceding circumstance are present, and the further required that the prior requisite, in case the provocation was given by the person attacked, that the one making the defense had no part therein. So ito yung defense of a relative. Okay? So dito, yung first two requisite ng self-defense are the same here. So dito, you have still the unlawful aggression, then reasonable necessity of the means employed to prevent or repel it. Pero dito, yung pangatlo. Okay? Yung pangatlong requisite dito, in case the provocation was given by the person attacked, that the one making the defense had no part therein. In case na yung tutulungan mo na relative mo o kapamilya mo, siya ang unlawful aggressor. Okay? Siya yung unlawful aggressor on this part. Pero hindi mo naman nakita mo siya kasi pagdating mo, sasaksakin na siya, di ba? Yun na. Uundayan na nasaksak. So nakita mo, hinabol mo ngayon, nilapitan mo, naagaw mo yung kutsilyo, and then, accidentally, napatay mo. Nasaksak mo yung ano, yung sasaksak sana sa kapamilya mo or relative mo. Okay? Provided that ikaw na gumawa ng defense ay walang kinalaman doon but only to defend your relative or your spouse or your family members, then you can invoke still of defense of relatives. So, part pa rin siya ng self-defense on the part of the relative. Ngayon, kahit ba sabihin na yung may sala, yung nag-provoke is yung ano, yung relative mo? Yes. Kahit na yung relative mo ang nag-provoke, but since tumulong ka lang, okay, hindi mo naman siguro makaya na basta-basta na lang, no? Tingnan yung relative mo na papatayin. Kaya nga, di ba? Tumakbo ka at hinabol mo and making sure that you will be able to defend your relative. Okay, so, that is very clear na kailangan talaga na madepensahan din natin yung ating mga relatives. Now, okay, so, and provided na hindi ka, wala kang intention doon. Okay? Wala kang party doon sa nangyaring unlawful aggression. Okay? As long as wala ka doon, then that is good. Okay, so, under the defense of relatives, of the three requisites of defense of relatives, unlawful aggression is the most essential and primary, just like in self-defense, without which any defense is not possible or justified. Therefore, in both cases, on the first paragraph and on the second paragraph, unlawful aggression is a condition sine qua non. Okay, so, kailangan talaga present si unlawful aggression in order for you to be able to invoke self-defense and invoke defense of relatives. Pag wala si unlawful aggression, you are criminally liable. You are not justified in your act na ginawa mo. Okay? Defense of a stranger. Okay, so anyone who acts in defense of a stranger or rights of a stranger, provided that the first and second requisites mentioned in the first circumstance of this article are present, and that the person defending be not induced by revenge, resentment, or other evil motive. Okay, so kung titignan natin yung sinasabi niya dito na provided the first and second requisites mentioned. Okay? Yung sinabi niyang first and second requisites mentioned in the first circumstance of this article are present. Ang ibig sabihin niyan, that is on yung dalawa, yung you are. Okay? You stands for unlawful aggression. Pangalawa is that reasonable necessity of the means employed. Okay? To prevent or repel it. So, pareho lang sila, no? Yung defense of a, yung self-defense, pareho sila ng first two requisites. Okay? Again, yung first, yung self-defense at saka yung defense of a relative has the same first two requisites as that of a defense of a stranger. Pareho silang tatlo. That one, there should be unlawful aggression. Pangalawa, there should be reasonable necessity of the means employed to prevent or repel it. Now, nagkakatalo na lang ngayon dito sa pangatlo. Okay? On the third requisite, kasi doon sa self-defense, pangatlo is lack of sufficient provocation on the part of the person defending himself. Okay? Well, yung sa pangalawang, sa defense of a relative, iba naman, hindi yun sa'yo. Ang nakalagay, in case the provocation is given by the person attack, provided that the first and second requisites, okay, the first and second requisites, provided that the person making the defense had no part therein. Yan yung pangatlo. Okay? So that is the third requisite sa defense of a relative. Well, in the defense of a stranger, yung pangatlo dito is that yung person defending, yun, ito sa last part, ito. Yung person defending be not induced, meaning hindi siya induced by revenge. So meaning, wala siyang galit sa tao, no, na kailangan niyang mag-revenge. Ano ba yung revenge sa Tagalog? Kailangan niya maghiganti. Okay. So wala. Pangalawa, resentment. Okay. Wala ding resentment. At yung pangatlo, walang other evil motive. So, again, in the absence of any of the three, being the first is the unlawful aggression. Kasi si unlawful aggression naman talaga yung pinaka importante, no? The primary and the most important requisite. Without the one, without the unlawful aggression, then lahat na yan, mawawala yung justifying circumstance. And you will become criminally liable. Okay, so yan yung mangyayari if wala si unlawful aggression. So again, pag kulang ng isa on the three, then walang justifying circumstance. Ang mangyayari is that there will be a, what you call that, you are criminally liable. Kaya nga naging justifying na siya kasi, yun nga, merong unlawful aggression. Kaya pinagbigyan ng batas that you will be able to defend yourself. Now, bakit ba we could say that yung defense of relative, yung defense of self, yung self-defense, sabihin natin na okay, naiintindihan natin kung bakit kailangan siya, bakit importante siya, no? Yung defense of relative naman, kasi we are thinking of our relatives. Pero, what is the basis of the defense of a stranger? Ano kayang basihan kung bakit sinama yung defense of a stranger? Now, kung ano yung gagawin mo na pagdepensa sa ibang tao, acting on the defense of others in the same condition and at the same place as those who act in defense of themselves. So meaning, if ikaw ang nalagay sa alanganin, then you want other person to also defend you. Diba? Kaya nga naglagay talaga yung batas natin ng provision for defense of a stranger. Kasi nga, hindi naman kayang dipensahan lahat ng ating kapulisan, yung lahat ng 100 million, 110 million Filipinos. So kaya nga, merong ginagawang krimen sa iyo, and then may nakakita na stranger, and then yung stranger na yon is matapang. Alam niya yung batas na hindi siya makukulong, he will be or she will be defending you. Then, tutulong at tutulong siya to defend you so that you will not be able to lose your life, limbs. Hindi mawawala yun. Yung life at saka limbs mo. Okay? So, if and when, darating din ang time na ikaw naman yung nakakita ng krimen, then hindi ka mag-aatubili na tumulong. Kasi nga, alam mo din na lahat, yung ibang tao is gagawin din sa'yo yung ginawa mo na pagtulong sa kanila. That is how a defense of a stranger is important at nailagay siya dito sa batas natin under Article 11 and ginawa pa siyang justifying circumstance. Now, in the paragraph 4, any person who in order to avoid an injury or evil or injury does an act which causes damage to another, provided that the following requisites are present. First, that the evil sought to be avoided actually exists. Second, that the injury feared be greater than that done to avoid it. And third, that there be no other practical and less harmful means of preventing it. Now, the term here is that el estado de necesidad, a state of necessity. Okay, so, example, okay, may namamaril. Okay. Habang naglalakad kayo ngayon dyan sa, tignan na lang, paglagay na natin, sa loob ng mall, naglalakad kayo. Nung palabas na kayo ng mall, eh, sakto, may tao na may daladalang Armalite. Ngayon, pinagbabaril kayo. Eh, nakita mo na patungo sa'yo yung pagpoint ng Armalite. May nakita kang matabang lalaki na kasabay mo sa paglakad. Ngayon, nagtago ka sa likod niya at siyang ginawa mong human shield sa shooting incident na yun. So, is your act justified? Okay. Yes, the act is justified. Because there is no greater harm to a person than to lose his own life. But the problem is, you are not criminally liable, but you are civilly liable because you benefited from it. Okay, yun. Okay, so, yun, dito papasok siya, no? Merong evil na i-avoid, yun. May namamaril. Then, ang ginawa mo, para hindi ka, siguro, mamamatay ka talaga kasi, di ba? Baril yun eh. Ang ginawa mo is, ginawa mo human shield yung matabang lalaki na kasabay mo sa paglakad. Then, yung inavoid mo is greater. Kasi nga, di ba, walang mas malaking harm the, sa isang tao is than to lose his life. So you have to defend and to preserve your life. And wala nang ibang practical and less harmful means of preventing it. Eh, on the line of sight kayo ng mamamaril, no? Kitang-kita kayo, wala kang pagtataguan. Paglabas yun ng mall, wala naman doon, di ba? Wala kang pagtataguan doon. So, yun yung pinaka-practical and less harmful on your part na ma-prevent mo na mawala yung buhay mo. Kaya, ginawa mo siyang human shield. Yan yung nangyari. Another example is that sa isang squatters area, so, paglagay na natin na sa mga 300 houses ang nandoon. And then, biglang nagkasunog. Okay? So, nung nagkasunog doon sa isang block, so, ang dami ng bahay, no? So, 300 kayo, sa ngayon yung nasusunog is nasa 20 houses pa lang. Then, yung isang block na tatawiran na ng, ano, ng apoy, if nakatawid yung apoy doon sa isang block na yun, consists of like 10 houses. If nakatawid yung apoy doon, lahat ng 300 houses will be burnt. Okay? Lahat yun masusunog, mauubos. Kasi nga, gawa sa light materials, ganun. So, ang ginawa nyo is that you call the persons, sabi nyo sa mga tao na magtulungan tayo, magbayanihan tayo. Okay? Gigibain natin yung 10 bahay na yan. Yan, yung nakaharang dyan. Kasi, habang nandyan yan, itong 200 plus houses is in danger of being burnt or masusunog. If nagiba natin yung 10 bahay na yan, then wala na, hindi na tatawid yung apoy kasi nga wala nang means to transfer because bigla niyong na-clear out yung area na yun. So magiging malinis yung area. And hindi na masyado nang malayo yung apoy. So, ang ginawa nyo, walang permission o walang permiso, okay? Hindi nagbigay ng patnugot yung may-ari ng mga bahay. Giniba nyo. Kasi nga, gusto nyo na ma-save yung 200 plus houses. Nagalit na yun ang mga may-ari. Are you criminally liable? No. Hindi kayo criminally liable. But you are civilly liable. Okay, so, hindi kayo criminally liable because it is a state of necessity. Diba? Kailangan yung gawin yon kasi nga, para hindi maubos lahat ng 300 houses. And yung pag Sunog ko yung pag-iba niyo sa 10 bahay na yon, okay? Justifies the act. Okay? Kaya yung nag-justify ng act niyo, okay? It justifies the act in order to save the remaining houses para ma-save yung mga naiwan na mga bahay na hindi masunog. Okay? So, therefore, there is no criminal liability on the part of those who destroyed the houses, 10 bahay. But there is civil liability on the part of those who benefited. Lahat ng bahay na hindi nasunog dahil ginaba yung 10 bahay na yon ay magbabayad ng civil damages or magkakaroon ng civil liability doon sa 10 may-ari ng bahay na yon. Because lahat sila benefited from it. Okay? Yan yung explanation dito. General rule, justifying circumstance has no civil liability. Exception, paragraph 4, because you benefited from it. And itong 5 and 6 are closely related provisions. So number 5 or paragraph 5, any person who acts in the fulfillment of a duty or in the lawful exercise of a right or office. And number 6, any person who acts in obedience to an order issued by a superior for some lawful purpose. Then, another one is that in the doctrine of self-help, ano ba yung self-help? The owner of a lawful possessor of a thing. Okay? So, kasi ito, right, oh, merong right. Okay? Kasama si right eh. Okay? So, and the doctrine of self-help, the owner of a lawful lawful possessor of a thing has the right to exclude any person from the enjoyment and disposal thereof. For this purpose, he may use such force as necessary to repel or prevent on or an actual or threatened unlawful physical invasion or usurpation of his property. That is on Article 429 of the Civil Code. So, if nakikita mo na meron ng nag-i-squat, okay? Meron nag-i-invade sa private property mo, papasok siya dito sa right mo. Okay? That is under your right. So, kailangan gawan mo ng paraan na hindi naman excessive yung mangyayari doon sa pag-disperse or pagpapaalis sa mga tao na gustong pumasok sa property mo. Now, let us have to take note that under paragraph 5, lawful exercise of a right, it is not necessary that there be unlawful aggression against a person charged with the protection of the property. If there is unlawful aggression against the person charged with the protection of the property, then paragraph 1 of Article 11 applies. That is according to Reyes. Okay? So, that is clear, huh? Under paragraph 5 dito, ito is under paragraph 5, lawful exercise of a right. Lawful exercise of a right. Yan. It is not necessary that there be unlawful aggression against a person charged with the protection of the property. When you are protecting the property, hindi necessary na there is unlawful aggression. Kung walang unlawful aggression, kung merong unlawful aggression against the person charged with the protection of the property, then you could invoke self-defense. Kasi nga, there is unlawful aggression. Ngayon, when you look at the fulfillment or duty, there are two and ito, tingnan natin. Dalawa lang yun, no? In the fulfillment of duty, there are two requisites only. Ito lang dalawa. And there was never any mention of unlawful aggression. Walang unlawful aggression dito sa dalawang requisite nito. So, when there is no unlawful aggression, then you can invoke paragraph 5 of Article 11. So, ito yung ikakaso mo. Okay? Fulfillment of a duty. Ito yung i-invoke mo na exempting, justifying circumstance. Ito. Ito yung gagamitin mo na justifying circumstance kung walang unlawful aggression. But if there is unlawful aggression in the lawful exercise of protecting the right, or your property. If there is aggression or unlawful aggression, then you could invoke paragraph 1, which is self-defense. Okay? So, I hope that is clear. Pag walang unlawful aggression, then we will invoke fulfillment of duty, Article 11, paragraph 5, justifying circumstance. If there is unlawful aggression na ginawa, and you are just defending the lawful exercise of that right, then you invoke paragraph 1 of Article 11, which is self-defense. Then, obedience of a lawful order, that is paragraph 6. Any person who acts in obedience to an order issued by a superior for some lawful purpose. So, requisites, first, that an order has been issued by a superior. So, kailangan yung superior ang nagbigay ng order, hindi yung kapareha mo ng rank. Second, that such order must be for some lawful purpose. Kailangan yung purpose is lawful. Okay? Then, pangatlo, that the means used by the subordinate to carry out said order is lawful. Even yung means o yung pamamaraan ng pagbibigay ng order dapat lawful din. Okay, so ito. Tingnan natin. Example. Nasa giyera kayo. So, you are in war. Okay? Sa giyera kayo, no? Then, along the way, nakakuha kayo ng mga prisoners of war. Meron kayo nakakuha na 8. Okay, so you've been able to capture 8 prisoners of war. Hindi natin alam kung anong terrorist type sila, pero ayun, nakakuha kayo ng 8. Okay? So, sabi na, tinanong mo sa superior mo, sir, anong gagawin natin sa 8 prisoners of war natin? Eh, kailangan pa natin kubkubin yung kabilang kampo nila, which is like 300 meters away. So, sabi ng superior niya, well, gagawin natin dyan is that patayin natin lahat sila. Ayan. The order is to kill them all. Okay, so, gagawin mo ba yun? Kung ikaw yung subordinate, yung sinabi ng superior mo, ganun. So, looking at the obedience to a lawful order, ayun, merong order na binigay yung superior, check. Okay, sabi niya, okay, ito yung gagawin natin. Patayin natin lahat ng ating prisoners of war. Wawalo yan. Patayin natin lahat yan kasi pabigat yan. Daladala natin yan pagtawid doon sa kabilang building. Now, yun bang order na yun is for some lawful purpose? It is not, di ba? So, hindi. So, therefore, kailangan, hindi mo gawin yung order na yun kasi alam mo naman na hindi yun lawful. The word obedience there is for a lawful order. And then yung pangatlo, that the means used by the subordinate to carry out said order is lawful. Ilawful ba na papatayin mo yun? No. That is against our laws. Sabihin mo, prisoners of war naman to, mga terorista. No, there is also a Geneva law on protecting the prisoners of war. So, they have also their human rights. So, therefore, yung order niya, nagbigay siya ng order, pero yung order is not lawful, then, pag gagawin mo yung order na yon, hindi siya lawful. Kasi nga, papatay ka ng tao na, even though kalaban niya siya ng government, enemy of the state, pero still they have human rights. So, kaya, hindi pwede ma-invoke yung obedience of a lawful order if pinatay mo siya. Now, let's have a quick recap. Okay, so, justifying circumstances are those where the act of a person is said to be in accordance with law, so that such person is deemed not to have transgressed the law and is free from both criminal and civil liability. Okay, another quick recap. There is no civil liability except in paragraph 4 of Article 11, where the civil liability is borne by the persons benefited by the act. Okay. Then remember that the basis of justifying circumstances, the law recognizes the non-existence of a crime by expressly stating in the opening sentence of Article 11 that persons therein mention do not incur any criminal liability. So in case of self-defense, kailangan kumpleto yung tatlo, yung URL na yon: unlawful aggression, reasonable necessity, and then lack of sufficient provocation. In case of defense of relative, yung first two again, present, unlawful aggression, then reasonable necessity. And then yung pangatlo is that kailangan yung magdi-defend is hindi siya kasama doon. You did not take part of it. Now, yung pangatlo naman na defense of a stranger, still the same, unlawful aggression and then reasonable necessity. But yung the last part naman doon is that yung tao na magdi-depensa is not induced by revenge, resentment, or evil motive. So, yan yung pag nag-state tayo no, ng ganito ang ano, ng self-defense. Yung articles, yung paragraph 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so, yan yung 1, 2, and 3 kanina na sinasabi natin. Okay, so again, thank you for watching and please subscribe to my YouTube channel, guys. Mga kapwa ko law students, I hope na meron naman tayo na impart sa inyo ngayon. Little knowledge lang, pero at least makatulong sana sa inyo sa inyong pag-aaral. And paki-share na rin ang video kung gusto nyo, no? And then leave a comment. Okay, so again, I am praying that all of us, mga law students, working or full-time law students, ay papasa this semester. Okay? And lahat tayo ay mag-move on papunta second semester na walang bagsak. Okay? In case merong mga subjects na bagsak tayo, huwag tayong mawalan ng pag-asa because that is just a temporary setback. So in every one step backward, we should have to do 2 steps forward. Huwag daw tayo maghinaan loob. Kasi sa law school, kung mababagsak man tayo or bababa yung mga grades natin, we are just being teach to be humble. Tinuturuan lang tayo na magiging humble, magiging mapagkumbaba. Okay? So again, God bless everyone and thank you for watching my video. This is your working law student, PH, saying to you, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow my Facebook page, Working Law Student PH. God bless us all and bye-bye.